To install Speedrow Topo, go to Edit menu, Preferences, come here. Go into the Add-on tab, click on Install, and select the zip file. Click on Install Add-on, and now you just have to activate it. After, you can open it and see everything here. To update Speedrow Topo, go to the Edit menu, Preferences, go in the Add-on tab, and in the Search tab, press, let's see, Rotopo. Okay, you will have Speedrow Topo here. Click on the Remove button, like that will remove the add-on. Save, restart Blender, and once it's restarted, go and install the add-on like previously. Install, select the zip file, install the add-on, activate it, and check the information, options, etc. Save the preferences, and it's okay. When you install any add-ons, you will be able in the preferences of the add-on, for example, I will search for Speedrow Topo, to have some information, some options, some keymaps, some links like that. Okay, so on all my add-ons, you will have that. You will also have that on, in fact, any add-on on Blender. So don't hesitate to check, if you click here on this little arrow, the options you will have on any add-ons, and like that, you will know what you can do with the add-on. So for example, on the preferences of Speedrow Topo, you will have some tabs, info, you will have a button to go on our Discord for support. Like that, you will have some information about the add-on. You will have a little text that will show you where is the documentation of the add-on. For example, if you click here, you will have Speedrow Topo documentation. Like that, you will be able to see the modifiers, like that, the tools, etc., etc. But also, I added it directly inside the add-on. If you go in the options, you will have the options here, show help in the UI, like that, and you will have everything here with some links, with video, with image, etc., etc. Okay? So, like that, you know what you can do with the add-on. In the information, you will also have a part for Rotopo empty. This one is not my add-on, but I added a link to help you to download it and to use it. Personally, I don't work on it, I don't update it, I cannot help you on this one, it's not my add-on like I said, so it's up to you to use it or not, okay? So, in the options, you will have some informations about the panel category. As you can see right now, it's in Speedrow Topo, you can change it. On the menu you will use, for example, I prefer to use a pie menu, and that will give me this, first because I don't have a Rotopology, but if, let's see, I add a little Rotopology, just to show you, I will have this pie menu, okay? Everything is there, and some objects, some buttons are fast to use, directly like that, clack clack, okay? So, let's continue. You will have the button size for the pie menu. You will have options to always show some menus, for example, the modifiers here, the tools here, the shading here, like that. You will have the number of faces of the reference object, because if your object has too much, too many vertices, you can decrease it. I will show you later in the documentation. Okay, you will also have the Rotopo settings here, so you will be able to choose some options. For example, if you want to start with a vertex, with a face, base surface, or polybuild. And depending on what you will use, you will have different options here. You can add a mirror, use the clipping option of the mirror, add a shrink warp, use some shading part like the hidden wire, wireframe, in front, and use a color. Like that, if you want to use a color. When you will save the preferences, the add-on will take those preferences into account each time you will use it. So you can edit your preferences here. For example, I want to start with a face. I want to use a color. I can change the color if I want, like that. And I can save my preferences. You will also have some quadro mesh settings, like that, same. You will be able to see them directly in the add-on. After you will have the keymap, you will be able to change it. You will have some links for my paid tutorial and my YouTube channel for free tutorials like that. Some of my add-ons and some other links. And that's it. It's as simple as that. In each add-ons on Blender, check the preferences. You will be able to edit them as you want. And one other thing is that SpeedRotoPo use three add-ons. It use B-Surface, like that. It use F2 add-on. In fact, you cannot use this one, but personally, I like to use it. And it will use the loop tools. When you will start a Rotopology, the add-on will automatically activate those three add-ons. Like that, you will have everything on the tools, etc., etc. As you can see, B-Surface. Those ones are loop tools. It's when you go inside in RMB and you will have this. Okay. So that's it for the preferences. When you are okay, save. And that's it. To start a Rotopology, you will have to select one object. This object will be the reference object of your Rotopology. The Rotopology object will use the same name, underscore Rotopo, and this reference object will be used with modifiers, with the shrinkwarp modifier, for example. Okay? So, the only part you need to use to start your Rotopology is the start Rotopo. The other part is to edit current Rotopo or to use Quadriflow. Okay, so click here, Start Rotopo. You will have the Start Rotopo button. You will have the tool you want to use, a vertex, a face, B-Surface, or Polybuild. Right now, I will use the vertex to show you. And you will have the settings under the tool. So you will be able to add a mirror modifier, to use the clipping of the mirror modifier, to use the shrinkwarp modifier to place the point on the surface of your reference object. The smooth shading, to have a smooth shading like here. The hidden wire, if you want. If you place your cursor, you will have information about everything. Okay. The use in front, to see your reference object in front of your, to see your rotopole object in front of your reference object. To see the wireframe, and if you want to change the color and the alpha of the object. Okay. So as you can see, this is pretty easy. All those settings are inside the add-on preferences, in the option tab, and in the Rotopology setting part. If you want to always use, for example, the face with a mirror clipping like that, save your preferences, and each time you will start a Rotopology, it will use those settings. Okay? Right now, I will use the vertex, and I will not use the clipping. So, my settings are okay, the tool is selected. As you can see, now I just have to click on Start Rotopo and it will be easy and fast. I created a single vertex that will be on my mouth. I can place it onto the surface with the snap tool, like that. And that's it. I created it. Now I just have to press E to extrude. Select both, press E to extrude again, or you can press Ctrl and RMB, like that. And everything is set up. I have my modifier, mirror and shrinkwrap, like that. I will have some tools to edit this rotopology. And I will add the shading to edit the shading of the topology. Okay? Let's delete this one. You can also use the face. I will select the same settings, start rotopo, and boom, you have this result. You can make a little rotation. After, you can do this. Boom! This is pretty fast. Everything is set up directly. If you use B-Surface, this time it will not do anything. It will only create the Rotopology object. So start Rotopo. As you can see, I have the name of my reference underscore Rotopo here. And this time you have to press D and draw. Like that. This is in fact the annotation tool. And just by making this, in the tool, click on Add B-Surface, and that's it, you created this. Bam! You can press D and draw. Select the vertex, vertices you want to use, and click on Add B-Surface. And that's it. Easy peasy. Pretty easy and pretty fast. Okay? Let's remove this one. The last one is Polybuild, but honestly, I don't like to use it because it's not finished. It will not use the snapping tool. It will not use correctly the shrinkwrap modifier. So I personally don't like to use it, but I will show you how to use it. Normally, you will have to click on Start Autopo. It should activate this one directly. And if you press Ctrl and click, that will create a single vertex. As you can see, you will have to move it after. You will have to press E to extrude, select both, E to extrude. I will recalculate the normal outside. And with this tool, as you can see, if I place my cursor here, that will highlight the edge, and I will be able to extrude. So those tools are pretty nice. As you can see, I like it. You can move this one, you can do this, like that. This is nice. But sometimes it will not use the snap tool. It will, if you place your object, it will not follow the surface, as you can see here. With control, you will just click and make this up. And as you can see here, this is not correct, like that. So it's not perfect. You will have to add a shrink warp. But as you can see, after that, it will not work perfectly. So let's remove the shrink wrap. So use this tool as you want. I put it here for you if you want to use it. But personally, I really dislike to use it. It's not working well with the basic Blender tools. So that's it to create a rotopo pretty fast. Select the tool you want, select the settings, start rotopo. So let's continue and we will see the other parts. I will choose the face. I will click on Start Rotopo and I will have this result. I will scale it, make this and make a little rotopology. Obviously, when you use a tool to start your rotopology, you can continue and use, for example, if you want to use Polybuild, you can. Like that. It's up to you. You can do whatever you want. You can also, let's select this, use B-Surface. Just press D and draw, like that. Select the vertices you want to use and click on Add B-Surface. Easy peasy. You're not limited to one tool. You can use all the tools you want. I will click on Align Vertices to Center and that's it. I can select everything and use the Relax tool, like that. You can select this, use the Space tool to make something clean like that. Up, same here, space. I will reselect everything and make a little relax, and that will work. Okay. So as you can see, this is pretty nice, pretty easy to use. I can press Ctrl R to add a loop here. And as you can see, it will follow. I will remove it to show you. I have this, I have my surface here, my reference object here. And if I press Ctrl R, bam, that will follow because I have a shrinkwrap modifier. So, I will show you the modifiers. The first one is the mirror. You can hide it. You can activate the clipping tool here. You can apply it, remove it. And if you want, you add another one. Same for the shrinkwrap. You can hide the shrinkwrap. You can see the difference. Like that. You can apply it, remove it. And you can update it. So if I apply it, I will have to add a new one. If I edit my object and I click on update, that will update the shrink wrap like that. So you will have to use this often because the rotopo with the shrink wrap is not perfect on this version of Blender, on the last version of Blender, in fact. Maybe they will improve all of this later, I hope. But right now, you will have to update the shrink wrap. You also can add a subsurf modifier. This one will be useful, for example, if you have an object with a lot of details and if you want to see if your rotopology is correct on your object. If it's not, you will have to add more loops, etc., etc. So this subsurf is pretty useful. I will remove it right now. So that's it for the modifiers. As you can see, this is easy. You will have the information here. You will have some videos to show you how to use them, etc., etc. The modifiers are pretty simple and pretty easy to use, just like that. You don't need to come here, but you just come here directly and use it. Now let's see the tool and let's see BSurface. So BSurface, like we saw previously, is pretty easy to use. First I will close this. I will press F to extrude, F to extrude. Right now, currently, I'm using the F2 add-on with the auto grab tool activated. Okay? So to use BSurface, you will have to draw some lines, like I said, like that. You will have to select some points and click on Add BSurface. As you can see, it will work. It will be really easy and fast. But be careful. You need to press 1, 2, 3, and this time that will work. If you add one more, let's see, here, and another one here, for example, and you select the point and click on Add BSurface, you will see the result will not be correct because the lines need to be 1, 2, 3, need to follow. You can not, for example, make this, after delete this and come here, select the point and add BSurface. As you can see, it will not work. Always do this, this, and this, select, add BSurface. This time it will work. And you don't care about the form of your, of this. In fact, this is not important. You can fix it pretty easily later. Just draw the lines like that. So, I will just clean it just by hand like that a little. Select this, align like that. And why not add a loop here. So like I said, I can use the space. I can use the space, I can use the space, I can control shift and select and relax. Bam! As you can see, it was easy and it was fast. So I made it to show you something with BSurface. So let's remove this one, delete faces. I will draw a line here that will follow this. I will come and select the loop here, but not the corner one, okay? So I have those vertices selected, my line here that will follow this, and if I click on Add BSurface, that will finalize all of this. Bam! And as you can see, this is nice, this is good, it works. So BSurface, like you can see, is pretty easy to use. You just have to be careful on your lines, like that. Select the point you want, Add BSurface, bam, that works. Same, I can make something like that, up, select this, 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 add BSurface. Sometimes you will have to clean, and as you can see, it will be easy and it will be fast. Sometimes you will have some issues, for example, if you make some lines, you select the point and you will see the other part of your object and it will not work. This time it will work, but sometimes it will not. So be careful, try to, for example, hide the mirror modifier and move it like that, and the tool will work perfectly. Okay? Did I forget something about the BSurface? It seems not. Yes, one. If you add a new topology, for example, I will start a new topology, let's see like that. This one, I want another color, up, 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 like that. And you come back on your object, you come back in edit mode, you will have to click to set the BSurface mesh. Click and boom, it will set it correctly. Because if you don't do this, up, let's come back, up, it will not work with BSurface. Just, as you can see, automatically click. And that will work, that will make it correct. And after that, you will be able to draw some lines and add BSurface. And when you will have something like that, you will click on Recalculate Normals Outside, and you can flip them if you want. I need to select everything, hop, like that. Okay? So be careful about this. And I think that's it for BSurface. Pretty useful tool. Let's see the basic tools here, the align, those ones. We will see center and freezing tool after that. Obviously, you will have some information and some video about each tool, like that. Hop. And we will see this. So, first, the align vertices to center. I will disable the clipping on the mirror. I will add, select some point and add some face like that. Hop, like that. Okay. I want to select with Alt all these center vertices and put them at the center of my object. So I will just have to click on Align Vertices to Center. And that's it. It's correct. That will work. If I disable the Snap tool, I will be able to press Ctrl R and let's see to make it like that. If I activate it, in fact, I press Ctrl R. As you can see, it will not work. Press Escape. Okay. So, the space tool, this one is from Loop Tools. Same for G-Strange, Bridge, Curve. This is an add-on that you will use a lot. So, Speed Rotopo will activate it directly when you will start a Rotopology. And this space tool is to, for example, if I select this point, Control Shift and this one, is to make each point at the same distance. Between each other. So if I press space, bam, as you can see, I will have this result. I can select this, space, and after, as you can see, the space is correct, I can select this, Control Shift, and this one, and click on relax. Bam! And you will have this result. This is not the same relax as this one. As you can see, you will not have the same result. This one will keep the border correct and will relax the inside part. Bam! And as you can see, you will have something perfect and something pretty nice. I can use B surface to finish all of this. Shift and deselect the corner. Add B surface. And that will give me this. I can select this one, Control Shift, space. Select this one, Control Shift to select everything and make relax. And as you can see, with this, you can pretty easily and pretty fast fix your surface. So you don't care about making something that is not perfect. Okay? So you will have this G-Strange here. This one is interesting. For example, if I do this, I will select this point and this one, and I will click on G-Strange, and it should place the point directly on this line. Okay, so this is an interesting tool. The curve one will work on loops. So if I select this one and this one and I click on curve, that will make a curve like that. You can edit the point as you want. It's up to you to do whatever you want. You can make regular or not, you can make cubic or linear, etc, etc. So if I place this one, I select those ones, curve, that will fix it a little. Okay? So sometimes I prefer to do this. It will work much better. The bridge tool, let's see. I will duplicate those ones. Shift D like that. Let's make a little rotation. And I can select this one and this one and click on bridge. And that will add a bridge on those points, and you can add here some segments if you want. Okay, pretty easy, nothing complicated. The grid fill, let's remove all of this. You will select the loop here, and you will click on grid fill, and that will give you this result. You can play with the span, with the offset, like that. Up, 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 up. Let's try to find a proper value. Well, okay. And as you can see, it will fix everything. So in fact, if I had removed this, it should work much better. Grid fill, bam. So this one is pretty useful. The remove double. So for example, if you have, let's see, one point on another one, like that. If you applied your modifier, I will select everything, in fact, and click on remove double. And I will be able to increase the value, and that will merge all the points like that. This is the same as un ta 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 ta. Where is it? Up in vertices. Bam 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 bam. In fact, I don't find it. Normally, it should be the merge as distance. Split separate. I will select those two. Merge by distance. That will be, in fact, the same as this. Okay. So, did I forget something? Yes, the recalculate outside. That will recalculate in the normal of the face outside of the object and not inside like that. So, depending if the mesh, sometimes that will work, some other time not. But if the mesh is closed, normally that should work correctly. So, recalculate outside, recalculate inside, as you can see. And if I select, let's see, this and this, I can flip them like that. So be careful because the shrink warp modifier will use the normals of the faces to make it correct. And after you will have the symmetrize. So if, let's see, I move this and I click on symmetrize, that will symmetrize my object. Let's fix this one, symmetrize. Be careful about this because if you place this like that, normally you should have a line here, but my code make it correct, so this is nice. And the symmetrize is pretty useful if you have this result. You can select this, select loop inner region, remove it, add a mirror, and once you are okay, you click on symmetrize and that will symmetrize everything and apply the mirror. The auto merge now is pretty interesting. I will activate it. You can play with the threshold or you can directly enter one of those two values. And the auto merge is like that. I can do this. I can press, in fact, press E. And if I place my point directly here, as you can see, that will work. That will merge. That will automatically merge the point. So press E like that. Okay, if I enter a small value this time, up, I will have to be really, really, really on it to make it work. But as you can see right now, it's not. So I can use the remove the bubble to fix it. So using the auto merge and the proper value will help you to gain some time like that. So that's it for the basic tools. The one that will be difficult to use, I think that will be the curve. It doesn't give you the same, the proper result all the time. You will have to fix it, etc. But the other one will be okay. Let's see this center tool here. The point of this one is to take some points and to make them that automatically go to the center when you will, for example, update the shrink warp. Because, let's see, I will extrude this just to show you. Up. Like that. Up. Like that. Okay. When I will do this, I will align them to the center, and when I will use, for example, this cult and move the point, that will move the point here, okay? So, if I set all of those points at the center tool, I will click on set, that will first automatically fix them, and if I use the sculpt tool and make this and update my shrink warp once I'm okay, because this move tool will not fit the shrink warp all the times, but you will have to update the shrink warp, and with the center tool set I will automatically have a proper result. So just like that, if I smooth all of this, update, as you can see, that will fix everything. If I add, let's see, some loop, like that, up. I will exit, smooth all of this, like that. Update the shrink warp, bam! With the center tool selected, set up directly, everything will work, will work correctly. I made it to not have to select each time and make align center, etc. So, you can select the point, you can unset the point, okay, If I select I have nothing, you can clear everything too. I can select and set like that. So now if I select it, it will work. So as you can see, this is a pretty useful tool because it will help you to gain a lot of time when you will update the shrinkwrap, when you will use this sculpt tool. Obviously, with this sculpt tool, you can activate the mirror here and that will work correctly. But sometimes, as you can see, even if it works with the grab, it will not work with this move if you press shift like that. So update it and bam, it's okay. And this is too bad that this tool doesn't use the mirror point and obviously the mirror itself. Okay, it doesn't take the modifier into account. That's why I made this. Bam, fixed. Defreeze tool this time, defreezing tool. This one is when you will make your topology, sometimes you will have some points that are like that, if you have several objects for example. And you want your topology to not go on this surface, you want to keep it like that, okay? So, I will apply the shrink warp, okay? I will disable the snap and I will make some extrusion like that. So imagine you made your rotopo, you have something like that, and if you add a shrink warp, bam, you will have this. And you don't want this, you want to keep this part here. So I will just select the point and I will freeze them like that. And now if I add a shrink warp, those points are not freezed. I can continue my topology like that easily, and those points are not freezed. Obviously, if I extrude those points, they will not be freezed. That will be freezed because I'm using the vertex group. And if you duplicate or extrude a point that has a vertex group, it will have the vertex group. Okay? You can select those points like that and unfreeze them or freeze them like that. You can select them and you can clear everything like that. Up, freeze, and that will work. So this tool is also pretty useful. Let's see the shading part. If you click on flat shading, that will flat the shading. It's like going in object mode and using the flat shad and the smooth shad. Okay. So this time it works in edit mode, flat shading, smooth shading. The hidden wire will hide everything and you will see like that your object and your reference under the object. It's pretty useful. The in front will give the we'll put the rotopo object in front of the reference object, and like that you will see correctly your object. The wireframe will show the wireframe of the object, like that. And the backfast curling here will just show the color on the view you put, like that. As you can see, the blue is visible when we see it like that, and it's invisible here. So it's pretty useful. The color allows you to change the color of your mesh to play with the alpha like that. You can remove it if you want or add another one. The color is in the add-on preferences. And that's it. One thing you can activate, in fact, is the face orientation. I will disable the backfast curling, and as you can see, let's go here, I have this result, let's remove this one. I have this result, I have red hair and the normal color hair, because in the add-on preferences of Blender, theme, 3D viewport, up, face orientation front, I put the alpha to 0, if not, you will have this. This is the basic part, I really dislike it. So I put the alpha to 0, and like that I can keep the face orientation, oh, come back, the face orientation always on, and like that I can see if I have some, let's see, I will just remove this one, I will flip those ones, I can see if I have some faces, some normals that are reverted. Okay, so as you can see, this is useful, like that. I can add color, do this, and come back here, and continue my retopology. So that's it for the shading part, and you will have some information here too. Since SpeedRotopo use, for example, the shrinkwarp modifier, or even the subsurf modifier, or the mirror modifier, if you use a reference object with a lot of points like this one, it can slow down Blender. Okay, so that's why I added the decimate point, the decimate tool. This one will decrease the number of points of your reference object. Like that, when you will make your retopology, it will be fast and easy. Okay, so I will show you. I will duplicate this object. As you can see, if I select an object with not a lot of points like this one, I don't see it. If I select an object with a lot of points, I will just activate, let's see, the statistic here. As you can see, I will have it visible. You can edit in the add-on preferences. You can edit where is it? In the menu settings here, the number of faces for the reference object. If your computer allows you to add, let's see, 10,000 faces, it's okay, enter the value. And if not, enter a value that is correct for you. So right now, as you can see, this one has a lot of faces. I will click on the decimate. You will also have the tool, the help here. I will click on the decimate and the tool will add a decimate modifier. You will be able to apply, to hide, like that. To remove it if you want, and to play with the ratio. So let's put less points like that, and as you can see, it will work. You will have something obviously that is not as good, but if you enter a correct value, let's see, like that, it will be much better and it will be enough for your retopology. Once you are okay, you click on apply decimate. And if it's okay, bam, you can start your retopology like that. Okay, so this tool is pretty useful to decrease the number of points of your object. And I suggest you to duplicate the reference object to be sure to keep a backup of your reference object like that. Let's see this subsurf part. So as you can see, I made a really fast retopology of my object, like that, hop, hop, hop. And the interesting part with the subsurf is to make something like that. I will activate the subsurf. I will remove the color and the hidden wire. I will activate this one. And if we check, you have your retopology, and under your retopology, you have the result of your mesh. Okay? So what you can do now is to add some loops, like that, and move the points, add the loops, etc. to be sure you will have something that will work perfectly, that will follow the better way your object, like that. And just like that, you will have something much better and you will be sure to have something perfect. So as you can see, that can be really, really useful. Just like that. You can obviously hide it if you don't want to use it and check some points to fix them a little. Like that. Up. And as you can see here, maybe I will move this one more here and this one more here. So it's up to you. Do whatever it needs. Add the number of points necessary to make it correct, like that, and to have something that will work. and the subsurf is pretty useful for that. When you will select an object, that is a rotopo object, and you will have some parts like the modifiers, you will be able to edit them. You will have some tools to recalculate the normal, outside, inside if necessary. The shading part to remove the shading, to remove the in front, etc., etc. So once you are okay with your topology, you can remove everything, make a flat shading if you want, or a smooth shading, and that's it. You will have all those possibilities. So this object is now a normal object, like that.